is fundamentally wrong about is that they don't actually look at decision making through the eyes of an individual human actor, with all the evolutionary biases of perception that entails, and all the evolutionary objectives that you may have in different points of your life. And they don't look at the life through the path-dependent eyes of that actor over time. And so I think the great value of the marketing mindset, and this is where you first of all start off by, I think, winning over, finding out what economists are on about, finding out what the assumptions are that underlie decision-making that has been polluted by contact with economic theory, and finding out how you can exploit that wrongness, is just to take this view where you look at life through the eyes of a human being, living life through time, rather than looking at a spreadsheet and having a perspective, which doesn't tell you very much at all. And I'll give you an example of this, okay, how the marketer can see things and problems that the economist doesn't. So I want to buy an electric car. And I went to the electric car dealership and said, show me your electric cars. And they said, well, it's a great time you've chosen because there's a government subsidy. About £5,000 if you buy a zero emissions vehicle. You'll get £5,000 subsidy. I said, great, I think I'm on for this. But before I buy an electric car, let me just go home and check that I can install one of those charging points at home. Because I don't want to spend £30,000 on an electric car and then spend the next 4 years with that cable coming out of my bathroom window. So let me look at the post, right? Okay. And so around the post people, they say, oh, it's great you've got this at the moment because there's a great subsidy. Normally it costs £500 to install a 7 kilowatt charging post. But there's a £250 subsidy, so you can get the post for half price. I said, hit me with it. I'm there. And they said, you've got to prove you're an electric car. So nobody in the Department of Transport actually read Catch-22, is my conclusion for this. Okay, but literally, I mean, what occurred to me as a marketer is a much simpler solution to the problem, which is provided you can persuade someone to get a charging post, you don't need to subsidise the electric car at all, do you? Right? Because once I pay £250 for an electric post at my home, and I can see that every time I get home there's this charging point there, my next car is bound to be an electric car because I feel like I might pick it if I'm going to want to do something. But no. So the solution to encouraging electric cars is simply to subsidise people who install charging posts and to help the rest of it. Once you want them to take, as Chairman Mao said, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. If you can get people to take the first step, subsequent steps tend to be quite easy. Now, just to be clear, not understanding this seems to be an extraordinarily extravagant way of incentivising human behaviour. To take an extreme example, making pension contributions. In fact, very interesting, a guy called Chetty has done work on this. The tax rebates that we pay on pension contributions, which of course are rebates that you don't really notice at all and that you don't see while you're paying the money in. Asking 25-year-olds to save money because they'll get a bigger pension when they're 55. Have you ever got a mobile phone shop and it says, sign up for this new contract and it'll give you a really good handset in 2047? Right? You haven't, because it wouldn't work. And yet when a bunch of economists design an incentive for pension saving, they think that's fine. Nobody in marketing would ever do an incentive where the tangible benefit is deferred. Interesting question, by the way. How many people here, if I gave you $500, probably got green on it, okay, right? And so you can keep this money if you've paid it into your pension before you get home this evening. How many of you know that? That's very interesting. That's about 5% of people. Now, assuming 50% of people have a pension, the first thing the government could do to encourage pension saving isn't to actually spend $24 billion of taxpayers' money. It's to make it easier for people to pay windfall amounts into their pension. And in order for me to do this, by the way, this is what I need to do. I have to go home, get my wife to open a filing cabinet, find out the address to send the extra payment to my pension provider, but guess what? An envelope, write a cheque. I don't even know where my cheque book is, but I've written a cheque for 6 months. Okay? Post it to my pension provider. But how can I know they got the money? The answer is I have to remember in 6 months' time when I got my pension statement to check that they'd actually credited me with the amount I'd sent. All of those things could solve pension savings at the cost of basically zero by simply making it easy for